So here's a 1916S. Now this is the lower minted out of the three. If you're not familiar with, you know, where the mint mark is gonna be, it's gonna be directly underneath the date if it does have a D or S mint mark. And this coin here is graded at an AU58. The coin sold for around $150. You know, I personally wouldn't pay $150 for that coin, but $150 for that penny. Now, if we look at a higher graded version of that coin, this coin here is graded at a Mint State 65 Red, and it's out of a famous collection. That's why the coin sold for over $18,000. So if you have a high grade, you know, even if this coin sold for $5,000, that's a big difference between $150. So if you have a really high grade, and especially that red grade, I've done a whole video on red pennies, red brown pennies, brown pennies, and the difference. Of course, red is always going to be better when it comes to coin grading and prices. So $18,000 for that coin. Now here is a 1916S mint mark. It is graded at Mint State 63 Brown, and this coin has a broad strike error taking place on it. So we can see that there around the rim of the coin, very noticeable type of error. This coin here sold for over $125. Now for the no mint mark, this coin here is graded at a Mint State 63 Brown, and it only sold for around $20. So nothing really valuable. But if we look at a high graded version, now this one is graded at a Proof 67 Red. So this coin here sold for over $34,000. That's right, super, super rare to have a coin like this in this condition, a Proof 67 Red grade. That's incredible. Here is the D mint mark. This coin here sold for around $150, graded at an AU55. Now here is the D mint mark graded at a Mint State 67 Red. Now this coin here sold for over $50,000. What would you do with $50,000? Let me know in the comments below. Here are some other wheat pennies that are worth money. On your 1936 wheat pennies, first thing you want to look for is doubling. So here is some examples of doubling taking place on the 1936 wheat penny on the lettering. So you can look for this with a USB coin microscope up close. It's really difficult to see it from a distance without a microscope. You can also look for that on Liberty. I do have microscopes available on couchcollectibles.com. Link's always in the description of every single video. If you're not sure how to get to the description, you can always do so by going underneath this video and pressing the little gray arrow, and it will show you the description, the gray arrow on the right to the bottom of this video. Also, look for that doubling on the date 1936 itself. So here is a few examples of that. A pretty extreme doubling here. Now it's pretty simple. You go to the bank, get a box of pennies. You find any pennies, you separate them by date, and look for the different errors on different year pennies. I got pretty much a video about almost every penny out there and different types of errors to look for on different dates. So once you go to the bank and separate those, you can look for these different types of errors. Now let's look at some prices here for the 1936 double die. Now this first coin here is graded at a very fine 35. So it's not got a mint state grade or anything like that. It looks like a regular penny that you would, you know, see in your pocket change, you know, pretty normal condition, I guess you could say. But it does have that doubling. It does have that double die obverse. So that is what's going to give it all of its value. This coin sold for over $175, even in this condition. Now, if we look at this other coin, now this coin here is only graded at genuine, and this coin does have that double die obverse as well, and this coin sold for over $325. So we go from 175, 325, and we even get more expensive as we go with the higher grade. Now this coin here is graded at a Mint State 63. It is a brown penny, so it's graded at a brown. And this penny does have that doubling again, and it sold for over $2,800. So of course, the higher the grade, typically in most cases, the more you're going to be able to get out of coins like this. Now that's not it. We go from a 175 to 325 to 2,800 to $12,000. Now we see that the penny before was graded at a brown. This is graded at a Mint State 66 Red. So of course you can tell the difference in coloration from a brown penny to a, what is considered a red penny. And this coin here sold again for over $12,000 because of its high grade and because of that doubling taking place on the front of the coin. You can really see the date being doubled here on this coin, as well as the word Liberty there. So always, always be on the lookout for that double die obverse on your 1936 wheat pennies. Now here is a Mint State 65 grade for the 1936 D Mint mark. And you would think, oh, it's a Mint State grade, it would sell for a lot. However, this coin only sold for $20. But if we look at a 1936 D with the Mint State 67 red grade, this coin sold for $4,000. So the grade, of course, is going to affect the coin tremendously in value. So always keep that in mind. It varies basically on every different type of coin out there. So that's what I talk about in my other videos. Feel free to go check those out. Now for the 1936 proof coin, this coin is graded at a proof 66, and this coin sold for over $8,000. And of course, look at the condition of that thing. That is an excellent, excellent condition. So that is why the coin sold for over $8,000. Now for the 1936 S, this coin only sold for around $30 at a Mint State 65 grade. But this coin here, the 1936 S at a Mint State 67 grade, sold for over $4,900. So nearly a $5,000 penny there. And then of course we have the 1936 S high graded coin. This coin sold for over $2,800, again because of its high grade. Here is a 1915 D Denver minted Lincoln wheat penny here. Now what makes this coin valuable is that it has an RPM. That means it has a repunched mint mark. So that D mint mark on the coin is repunched. Now here's an example of what a repunched mint mark can look like. This is actually on a 1927 D wheat penny, but we're looking at the 1915 D, so it could look a little different. You never know. Repunched mint marks vary based on many different things. But if you want to see your coins up close like this, you can get that coin microscope on couchcollectibles.com. Now this 1915 RPM here sold for a little over $50, but it doesn't have a high grade. It's only graded at a fine 12. So if this coin was graded at, like, you know, a really high grade, it's gonna sell for a lot more money. Next up is a 1915 S wheat penny here. Now this penny has a lower grade, so I'm gonna show you a lower grade compared to a higher grade. Now it is graded at about uncirculated 58, so it's not like extremely low, but it's also not considered a mint state coin because mint state coins go from 60 to 70. This is graded at a 58, about uncirculated. So you will see the difference with what this will sell for in comparison to the next coin. Now this coin, because of its grade, sold for over $400. Now for the 1915 S, they only did mint, they only made or produced 4.8 million of those coins. So keep that in mind as well. That is the lowest mintage of the 1915 penny. You got the 1915 no mint mark, the 1915 D, and the 1915 S. Now if we look at a high grade of the same exact coin, a 1915 S graded at a Mint State 66, we're going from a $400 coin to a $46,000 coin. So this penny here sold for over $46,000 just because of that high grade. If we move on to the no mint mark 1915, this is graded at about uncirculated 58, just like the other one as well. Now they did make 29 million of these no mint mark pennies from 1915. So they made a lot more than the San Francisco minted penny, but this coin still sold for over $60, so not huge money. But if we go to the high graded version of this coin, a 1915 no mint mark, Mint State 67 grade on this coin, this penny sold for over $20,000. $20,000. Now if we look at the 1915 D Denver minted Lincoln wheat penny here, well, again, we got the same grade, AU58. So that's going to be the lower grade in comparison to the two that we're comparing here. And it sold for over $125. Now again, if we go to the high graded version of the 1915 D, this one here is graded at a Mint State 66. And this penny sold for over $23,000. Don't forget to subscribe in the middle. Check out the videos to the left of me. And until tomorrow, I'll see you all in the comment section below. This is Couch Collectibles, and this is where I disappear.